action potential curve for a ventricular myocyte, while this is the curve for its mechanical response. Whenever the depolarization starts, the mechanical response will also start from that place, and till phase 2 there occurs the systole phase, and after phase 2 occurs your diastole, that is relaxation. This you can correlate with phase 3 of action potential, because when the during the phase 3 the calcium channels get closed, so the intracellular calcium levels will get fall, resulting in the relaxation phase. And then the absolute refractory period is up to half of your phase 3, and other part of the phase 3 and phase 4 is your relative refractory period. You can see from here the systole will fall completely under the absolute refractory period. So whenever there exists a stimulus during, whenever you apply a stimulus when the muscle is already in the contraction phase, that is systole, there occurs no response. There will be no response since it is under the absolute refractory period. From this we can infer that cardiac muscle cannot be tetanized. Consider the mechanism of contraction. So whenever the action potential reaches the T-tubule, the extracellular calcium will enter the sarcoplasm, resulting in increase in the calcium concentration. This calcium goes and binds to your troponin C. Troponin C, it has troponin, you know, the troponin tropomyosin complex will mask the active site in your actin. So whenever calcium goes and binds with the troponin C, the tropomyosin will laterally displace from its active site, thus exposing its active site. So what happens, the myosin head will bind to an ATP, okay, and that ATP will hydrolyze, resulting in ADP plus inorganic phosphate. So this results in the release of energy. This provides energy for, which provides energy for the binding of your myosin head to your actin. Initially it is at 90 degrees. So whenever after that the ADP, the bound ADP and the inorganic phosphate will get released from the myosin head, and thus it results in a conformational change in the myosin head. So from 90 degree it will go to 45 degrees, thus resulting in the sliding of actin filament. This is what we call as your power stroke, okay. Then after that, after the power stroke, another ATP will come and bind to the myosin head, and this will decrease the affinity for affinity between the actin and myosin, thus dissociating them. Very well, infer from here that the cardiac muscle, the cross-bridge cycle is similar to that of your skeletal muscle fibers, while it is sensitive, the contractility is sensitive to phosphorylation, okay, which is similar to your smooth muscles. So the cardiac muscles share both the properties of your skeletal muscle and the smooth muscle. Considering the relaxation of your cardiac muscle fiber, this happens due to the fall in the sarcoplasmic calcium ion concentration. How this calcium ion concentration falls? In the membrane of the sarcolemma, you have the sodium potassium ATPase, right? The sodium is pumped out and the potassium is pumped in, right? So this provides a gradient for sodium to enter the cell, right? So this sodium entry, it is facilitated to through sodium calcium exchanger. For two sodium to come in, one calcium is expelled out, thus the intracellular calcium levels falls, resulting in the relaxation. This happens through the removal of calcium from the troponin C, and the masking effect is again come into play. Important drug which is related to this is your digitalis and other cardiac glycosides like aubaine. How these act is that this digitalis will go and inhibit your sodium potassium ATPase. Whenever this channel is inhibited, this only provides gradient for this one, because this is a secondary active transport. So this gradient for sodium is also inhibited. So calcium cannot move out of the cell. So inside the cell, the calcium concentration will get increased. So whenever the calcium concentration is increased, the contractility is increased. So this is used as a drug for heart failure. Considering the side effects of the drug digitalis, its usage nowadays is very much reduced because over inhibition of the sodium potassium ATPase will result in a depolarized cell for a longer time, because the sodium potassium ATPase only allow the sodium to go out. Whenever the sodium is not going in, the positivity builds up in the cell, resulting in a depolarized cell. Okay. So whenever the cell is depolarized for a longer time, it slows down your conduction. Also, the increased intracellular calcium levels, it also causes ill effects to the cardiac muscle. Digitalis is also used in case of atrial fibrillation and atrial flutter. Okay, what is the difference between these two is, in case of fibrillation, the atria beat at a faster rate irregularly, it is not in a regular manner. But in case of fluttering, the atria beat at a faster rate regularly. Okay, so in both these cases, digitalis is used. How this digitalis acts here is, it reduces the number of impulses that is transmitted through AV node. Okay, and thus controlling the disorder. Let's see about the metabolism of your cardiac muscle. So the cardiac muscle is very much mostly depends on fat, okay, and then carbohydrate, and then ketones and amino acids. Okay, so fat, almost 50% of this fat comes from your free fatty acid, and this criteria, it is very much changeable. It alternates according to a nutritional status. Like when you have taken a food which is rich in glucose, then pyruvate and lactate uptake by the heart is increased. When in case of your fasting or severe starvation, fat consumption by the cardiac muscle is increased. And in case of DM, it is important to note that the carbohydrate utilization is decreased while fat utilization is increased. This can be correlated with the glucose transporters. Like in case of heart, you have two major glucose transporters, GLUT4 and GLUT1. So in case GLUT4, you know that it is sensitive to insulin. In case of DM, in both two types, whenever it is deficient, the insulin is deficient, or it is the cell is resistant to insulin, GLUT4, it is down regulated. So the glucose uptake is decreased.